Hey everyone, welcome back to The Walking Dead. We're gonna continue episode 1 where we left off. Which was there. What a lovely day! Hey! That's pretty good! All you new subscribers will remember this.
Bop!
Bop. I said new, not old. New. Fucking idiots. I talked to you, bitch. Turn down the fucking brightness, cause it's too damn bright. There. Now it's a little less bright.
Everything okay?
Mm-hmm.
Hey there. This is Glenn, and I'm kinda in a jam here. Little girl, if you're there, can you put your daddy on the phone? On the talkie or whatever.
This is Lee. What's up?
So, I'm down at that motor inn, and, well, I'm stuck.
Stuck?
Yeah, I saw a chance to get some supplies for the group, and a bunch of the Roman ones had to jump on me. I might hear, but they won't leave.
What's up? Glenn's trapped down at the motor inn. Hey, Glenn, we're gonna talk it over and send a group to come get you, alright?
Awesome. I'll sit tight till then.
Sounds good. I'm gonna hold on to this until we get Glenn back, okay? I'll take good care of it.
What do you think?
I think Doug's not great around zombies. You got your family here. I'll take Carly and her dead eye down to the motor inn, get Glenn, and get back here as fast as I can.
If that's what you want to do,
somebody's got to.
Yeah, I'm in.
Good. Doesn't sound too bad there right now.
Let me know as soon as you want to head out. I could use a job.
I don't know about you guys, but I'm ready to go out now. Energy bar. I'm gonna need that.
We can't let anything happen to Ducky.
I know, but it's that much for the boy. Oh, thanks, Lee. He appreciates it.
That's sweet, Lee.
Hey, Lee. Really gave that old man hell.
Yeah. We got pushed, you know?
You don't have to tell me. I was ready to tear the man's head off. Anyway, we, Cap and I, appreciate your support.
Thank you, Lee.
Ah, shit.
Are you guys all right?
We're just fine, considering.
How about you, Cap? Yeah.
We've all been through a lot.
Lee, you got a second?
Sure.
Back on Herschel's farm.
Yeah.
I panicked, you know. I'm not proud of it.
It happens.
I guess. But I can't stop seeing him in my head. We could have saved him together.
You didn't have a choice. You think you do when you look back on it. But in a moment, when things are really out of control, you don't have a choice.
I guess.
Try to let it go. You're a pretty good shot.
Well, you don't fuck with a reporter, especially one that's 3 days out from her last cup of coffee.
Oh my gosh.
You ready to do that?
Come on, Max. Seriously.
Yeah.
Come on. Let's go. You stupid shit. Yeah, that's right. Go away. Fucking idiot. Go away. Stay there. Dipshit. You can lie down. I don't give a shit where you lie down. Just get the hell away. You guys can watch the cutscene if you want. Stop.
Did you see that? Notice us?
Not yet. There's a survivor trapped up there.
No way. We gotta go now.
Listen, I was out here looking for gas. Then, up there in the corner room, I heard crying coming from inside.
Who is it?
It's a girl. I talked and she got frightened. I was trying to give her some help, and then she started yelling and saying I was bitten. I tried to convince her I wasn't, and that's when all these guys came out of the forest. A couple almost got me. And I ended up hiding in the ice machine.
Lucky you. Now let's go.
We can't just leave her.
Damn right we can.
You guys are suicidal.
No. I'm saving her. With, without you.
Think about it if it was you.
Right, let's go save Glenn's damsel in distress. Where to next?
Oh man, she's eating something. So we got that one right there, close. And I was behind that door. It was too soon to be on the set. Hey man, that drew some attention. Be careful.
I think I found a pretty damn good way to stop these guys quietly.
Now we just have to get it quietly.
I need to go over here. I'm so confused.
Good luck smothering them to death.
That's not really what I have in mind.
So I know what I can do. I I think I could take out that one with, that one right there with the pistol and the pillow. Stealth kill.
Get out your gun.
What the noise?
Just follow my lead. Stay right behind me.
That was sick.
Get out now. Or not. Wait, isn't there a part in a spark plug that can shatter glass?
Wait. Let me see the spark plug. Who's inside these things turns carbon into tissue?
Run back over here.
Dude, where'd your weapon go?
Into that ice pick sized hole.
Holy shit. It's cool. Now we've got this.
Are you two done?
Two more.
That should help.
Why don't you guys lag behind just in case this goes to hell?
We'll be right behind you.
Yeah.
Hello in there. We're here to help.
Please just go away.
Let's go, guys.
In a minute. If you open up, we can take you somewhere safer. We've got a group in town.
No.
She's in trouble.
Miss, we're coming in.
You might want to break through that board first.
Stop! Just stop! Coming out.
You're hurt.
Oh, God.
I said stay away.
We need to get you help.
It's too late for that.
Guys, she's been bitten.
What?
I told you, I said go away! I'm bit! But you couldn't just leave.
Let's calm down. You could be fine.
I won't be fine. My boyfriend was bitten. You get sick and you die and you come back and you kill anything you can find.
You have a boyfriend?
Glenn.
I don't want that. It's not Christian. Please, just leave me. Please go.
What are we gonna do?
You have a gun.
So?
Can I borrow it?
What do you mean, borrow?
Give it to me. I can just, you know, end this, and then there's no problem.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Please, I don't want to be one of them. They're satanic.
Give it to her.
What? You can't be serious.
Do it.
No.
Look at her, Carly. There's no happy ending to this.
Okay. Fine.
Thank you so much. I know how terrible this must be.
We can't watch this. Let's go.
We can't go yet.
What? Why not?
Because somebody needs to pick up the gun. Can't leave. You two go on.
Okay.
You sure?
Yeah. God bless you, right?
God bless you too.
I didn't even give her the fucking gun. That's...
Everyone what are you... all right?
Yeah.
We had some close calls, but Glenn is fine. We'll get it. We're okay.
I've got a few cans of gas for the pickup of the truck in the car.
Good to hear it.
And things back here?
Why? Her friend is still in and out. We won't survive any more stress. The next order of business is getting those pills out of the pharmacy. Try to get some rest, hon.
How can I with those things out there?
Heard or seen anything?
Nothing, luckily. Wanna step outside, have a look around?
I'm not suicidal yet.
No, the gate out there is closed. We can hang out in front of the store and be fine.
Sure. Let's go have a look around.
Cool. And we'll keep it down. Don't need to bring him back this way with any unnecessary noises.
Agreed.
Ugh.
Just eat.
As far as I can tell, it's all terrible.
gets you.
They eat you. And whatever's left comes back as one of them. I think it might be more than a couple days before all of this gets sorted out.
Yeah, I think so too. We better keep it down out of here. Think you can do anything with this?
No, I could do.
What's that?
It's universal. Program it to work with those TVs across the street. Just hope the power's still on.
You can just do that?
I memorized all the codes when it was in AV. Let's try it.
Well, fucking done, Doug. All that dork nonsense might save a life.
Who's to say it already hasn't? Of them to take notice.
But not enough.
Oh, Brett.
Can't reach that brick.
Hey, man, what are you doing? We can't even think about going out there unless the keys are out there for sure. Hey man, what are you doing? We can't even think about going out there unless the keys are out there for sure. Hey man, what are you doing? We can't even think about going out there unless the keys are out there for sure.
At the drugstore and died with keys in his pocket.
It would take a lot of effort to make it safe enough to go out there and see if he has the keys. If we could somehow prove that he worked here, I think it'd be worth it.
I'll see what I can find. Can't reach that brick.
Hey man, what are you doing?
Oh my
God. I can't think about going out there.
Stop it, Doug. You're being stupid.
Did you guys try to get in there and get weapons?
We did, but it was too risky. And then a bunch of guys showed up and they tried.
Then what happened?
I think they're most of who you see wandering around out
there. Yeah, that's a hasty fortification job over there.
Yeah, it didn't work.
We proved that that guy worked here. And then we can try to clear the street to search him for the keys.
Yeah, probably easier said than done.
Those TVs are on, and I'm sure they're making a lot of noise behind their glass. We should think about searching that guy across the street.
Maybe he has them, but who knows if he actually worked here.
Let's head back inside.
Okay.
What are you messing around with there?
A radio. I can't get it to work, though.
Here, let me have a look. batteries in this thing.
What now?
You know that there are no batteries in that thing.
Yeah, of course. I mean, yeah. No.
I just gotta find some. Needs two.
Thanks. I wouldn't even really know what to look for.
Take your battery.
For the lock on the gate outside.
Why?
Oh, you know, I thought I'd go stretch my legs.
You're probably better off breaking it if you have to.
What's your next move?
I don't know. I mean, you guys seem okay.
What about your family?
Yeah, I...
Forget it, man. That's your business.
I hate feeling like I can't do anything.
I know the feeling, man. Back to the motor.
How can it be that bad so fast?
You know, when things are taken away, people do crazy shit.
I guess. That's not me. I'm not giving up. Not for anything.
Good. Good.
You let her do it, you know? You said give her the gun.
I know I did.
Why the hell would you do that?
She was dead. It was over for.
You better hope you're never bitten, then.
No shit. Try to get some rest.
Yeah, right.
Find anything?
It's a photo of the family room, this place. Might help us track down the keys to the office.
I know who you are. You're Lee Everett. You're a professor at Athens who killed a state senator who was sleeping with your wife. This is your parents' store. Folks around town know the owner's son got himself a life sentence, but I'm a reporter for WABE in Atlanta. I paid attention to that trial. Maybe you're a murderer, but I don't really care. Frankly, that's a skill that might come in handy. Did you tell anyone out there who you were, or that you were tied to this place?
No. Sticking to first names for a reason.
Well, good. You seem like an okay guy, and the last thing we need is drama out there. You've got this little girl to take care of. Look, don't make me wrong on this.
I don't plan to.
Good. Because if this lasts longer than a few days, and you're a detriment to the group, then we'd have a problem.
I hear.
I'll just keep it to myself.
Thanks.
Don't worry about it.
How's your friend?
It's okay. Thanks for fixing it.
keep looking around.
Okay.
That's not the way I want it to go, you dumb.
Wanna head back into the drugstore with me?
Okay.
Okay.
Lee?
Yeah?
You're not bad, right?
What are you asking me there?
That lady said you killed someone. Was that because he was one of the things trying to eat you?
It's complicated. Sometimes things happen. We do things and can't explain them. Let's head back to the others.
Alright, so now I can tell Doug that he worked there. I have the fire axe. So that means I can get the key, so hey, fat ass.
How are we doing?
Good. Wanna go have a look around outside?
Yeah. Let's have a look around.
Okay.
Hey man, what are you doing? We can't even think about going out there unless the keys are out there for sure.
Oh yeah, I forgot to show you the pictures.
Those things like TV.
At least the sound of it. If they were louder, we might be able to clear the street.
Come on, I'm showing the fucking pictures.
Let's head back inside.
Okay.
Come on, why don't you show me the fucking picture, you fucking whore. Yeah. Alright, I'll talk to your bitch again.
I'm gonna get back to him.
Sounds good.
That was fucking fast. Is that a bowl? I can give this shit to Carly now.
This battery should fit the radio.
Great, thanks.
And here's another.
Should be able to get it to work now.
It's still not working?
Yeah, I can't figure it out.
Let me have a look at that thing.
Go ahead.
Nothing. See the battery compartment. Hubba. Yeah. Sure.
You all right, Lee?
I'm okay. Thanks.
From here in Macon?
That's right.
Where are they? Should we go looking for them?
It's not our business.
Better get back to getting those cat's nips.
Take your time.
Alright, guys, I will see you in the next one, and I'll make sure to record more next time. So, bye-bye!